All right. Now notice I was cut off. Verse 18, chapter 3, book of Ephesians. See, it's right there. See there? 18. That you may be in strength to comprehend with all the saints. With all the saints. That's everybody together. What is the breadth, the length, and depth, and height? Right? And I attributed that to the 1,500 square mile New Jerusalem City, you know. But that's just, I just put that there for notes because I'm going to do more study on that. Because that describes a cube. The length, the breadth, the depth, and the height. Or, you know, whatever. Might be a rectangle, but, you know. What it is, whatever. In other words, the fullness of wisdom. Understanding, right? To become mature. He's talking about maturity. Right? Why? Because they're being shaken. Paul's getting beat up. They're being shaken. Right? He says, I don't want you to be shaken. I'm praying, man. I'm not praying that I'm not going to get beat up anymore. So I'm praying for you. That you would comprehend, be strengthened and comprehend with all the saints. That's everybody together on the same page. About the same gospel. The same understanding. Whew. Verse 19. To know also the love. The love. To know also the love. This is part of the manifold. Manifold wisdom. To know the love of the anointed. That's Yeshua. That is exceeding the knowledge, that you may be filled to all the fullness. Let's look at that. Verse 19. To know also the love of the anointed that is exceeding the knowledge. Yeah, love. What's the greatest of all these? Remember Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 13? It says the greatest of all these is love. And he's dealing with all these people, you know, prophecies, prophets, teachers, the gifts of the Spirit that were temporarily just for the early church to build up the early church, to fill them up, to make them mature. And once they became mature as a man, and time and history and place, the early church, they became mature, all those gifts passed away. No more prophets, no more, you know, anyway, all those gifts that were there, okay. So he says, to know the love of the anointed that is exceeding the knowledge, that you may be filled to all the fullness of the Most High. To become mature, full, filled. Unshakable. Never moved. To automatically know when someone says, oh, this is the truth, brother. You know right off the bat, bull pucky. That ain't the truth. No way. You know it right off the bat. As soon as you hear them open their mouth, just usually just takes one sentence for me. And not only that, I can just feel it emanating out of them. I can just feel it. Why? Because I can feel their pride. We can feel men's pride. We can feel it. It just emanates and oozes right out of them. We can feel it. It's in the air. The work of man's own hands. It's pride. Ego. Right? Right. We're trained. Become experts at discerning. Anyway, to know also the love. The love. Remember the new commandment? The new commandment I give unto you. Love your brother. We're not under the law. Love is attainable. To love our brother. And how do we love our brother? By speaking. speaking the truth of the gospel, the one gospel, one message, one truth, one understanding, one wisdom. There's only one. All other gospels are no gospel at all, Paul says. That's no gospel at all. And everything else falls under the law of Moses. Everything. Why? Because the law was given to man right from the get-go. The command was given to man right from day one. Most High told Adam, thou shalt not. Everybody's under that law. Whether they know it, whether they want to acknowledge it, or not. That is no gospel at all. And in all the different varieties that are out there of New Age, Quim Age, Quack Age, Whack Age, Hindu Age, Muslim Age, Buzzlam Age, Hindu, Dako, Rika, Binga, Israel, Donka, Bonka, Binka, whatever name you can come up with it. It's all the law. It's all the works of man's hands trying to attain unto the unattainable. They've convinced themselves, we're going to get our eternal life. No, you're not. Your eternal life was taken away because your great-great-great-great-great-grandfather Adam lost it for you. And there's only one way to get it back, and that's through the access, the truth. You know, I might be a little hard and dramatic and whatnot, you know, and I should be nice and kind, and I'm trying harder at it. But remember this too. These videos are just for me. I watch them. If I was talking to you in person, I wouldn't be talking to you like this. I would be totally self-controlled. I know, because I've experienced it. I've talked to people about it. I'm totally different in person than I am on these videos. These videos are just for me. I watch them. They're my personal diaries. I learn from them. I watch them. I learn from them. I curtail myself. I adjust myself by watching them. And just because we have YouTube up here, that's what gives me the motivation, right? Knowing that people are going to watch them anyway, that gives me motivation. It works. It's a tool for me to use. And man, what a wonderful tool. Because people can see it too, you know, and they can get whatever they want out of it. You know, a little peek into my life, into my diary. How about that? Wow. Now, if I was up on a stage, it might be a little bit different, you know. I might be more dramatic, right? But I would probably have more control. But anyway, getting back to the book. Okay. Verse 20, chapter 3, book of Ephesians. And to him who is able above all things to do exceeding abundantly what we ask or think according to the power that is working in us. Okay, what is it, that is the exceeding thing here that Paul talks about? Well, it's in the prior verse, verse 19 we just read. Let's look at it again. To know also the love, the new commandment. He wants us to know the new commandment. And that new commandment is exceeding the knowledge. It exceeds it. Believe it or not, I need to do more study on it, but I do have somewhat of an understanding and a grasp of it. It exceeds the knowledge. It exceeds the knowledge. Okay, now I just had another revelation, okay? It exceeds the knowledge. This is the early church. Paul's dealing with an early church, the Gentiles. They're learning about knowledge, right? They're still maturing into the love. right? The love, once they get to a matureness of the love, it's going to exceed all these things they're learning, all these different knowledge pieces they're putting together. All right? So that's why he says, verse 20, and to him who is above all things to do exceeding. In other words, the Most High is gonna bring us into growth. He'll bring us into growth. Right? Exceeding abundantly what we ask or think according to the power. All right? What's James say? If any of you lacks wisdom, ask. Even as we're babies and young men, young boys, even mature, we want more insight. We want more understanding into this particular part and that. We ask. Ask the Most High. And He'll give us that He'll give us bring us into the new commandment, love, the love, what it is to love our brother. He'll teach us what it is to love our brother, to have a fullness, to be full with the understanding and that wisdom. And a lot of the ways He teaches us when we ask Him is He sends someone to us to talk to us, and maybe a vid. How about that? verse 21. To Him is the glory in the assembly. This little early church. These little early churches that I'm going around from country to country, city to city planting. The assembly. The little early churches that are growing in love. The assembly. In the Most High. To all the generations of the ages of the ages. And He says, Amen. And that's the end of chapter 3. Now we're going to go on to chapter 4. And that will be it. Chapter 5 and 6 you can read for yourselves. Because it's more, you know. But